We now place ourselves in the loving presence of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the heart of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to release what is right and just, and always to rejoice in his consolation. To Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. From the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." Thomas said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in the midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hand, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. The Lord be with you. Good afternoon, good evening, and good morning.
Good evening, Father.
I'll give Tita Bell 2 minutes to introduce our new member. Tita Bell.
Oh. We have a new member. Her name is Rosalie Kamala Kausing. And she's my patient and my friend. And I invited her over because she has a very great story to tell about her life, about her journey in life. And I was so happy. I'm so happy that she responded to my invitation. That's why she's here. And I told you, Sal, that we have a spiritual director, Father Danny Montaña, a rogationist, a religious from Silang, Cavite. And all the members are a mixed, actually, doctors from the U.S. Tita MJ is our leader. And we have from Manila, Tita Belen, Miga Belen, Tita Helen, Tito Manny, Tita Gray, Tita Linda. I told you that Tita Linda is our professor in CIM. Then the youngest of the group is Ate Irene. Inday Irene.
Inday Irene.
Our own. And we have others, but they're not yet here. So we will introduce you to them when they come. Father.
So welcome, Mom, and enjoy the moment with us. So today we have the story of St. Thomas, the apostle, although he was absent, but then beautifully the second reading of the day in the office of the reading said, he was absent, then he came and heard. He heard and doubted, doubted and touched and believed. That's why the second reading asks, what's the significance of his coming together, of his absence and his coming afterwards? But everything is in God's providence. In a marvelous way, God's mercy arranged that the disbelieving disciple, in touching the wounds of his master's body, should heal the wounds of our disbelief. It's so nice to see Thomas, perhaps doubting in many ways, because he's not heard Jesus has not seen Jesus. But afterwards, when he saw Jesus and touched the nail prints in his finger and his side, he simply made the profession of faith. My Lord and my God. That's the shortcut profession of faith. That's the faith he was able to put in front of the Lord, truly believing in Jesus. But of course, the Lord says, blessed are you, Thomas, because you have sinned. But blessed are those who have not seen yet believe. We have not seen the Lord, yet we believe. We believe in the many proclamations. We believe in the sacraments. We believe in our prayer. We believe in each other because of the name of the Lord. So the Lord Jesus instilled in us that belief in order for us to grow and to grow in order for us to gain eternal life. That's our belief in God. That's our belief in Jesus Christ. And hopefully, as we celebrate Mass, as we celebrate sacrament, there we are. We can say, my Lord and my God, you are truly present among us. You are truly present in us. And the more we do that one, the more our faith will grow. The more that we do that one, the more it enhances our life. The more we do that one, it leads us to acknowledge Jesus as our King and Savior, Lord of all, because he's risen from the dead. This resurrection is none other than the story that is to reveal in us. And then revealing to us, we go as well into our resurrection, into our ascension, and into the heavens of God. Amen.
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 Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you for Thomas.
Thank you for Thomas.
A disbelieving disciple. But this disbelief turned our unbelief into joy.
It turned all of us.
You are loving Jesus. And we will always hold on to that.
And we will always hold on to that.
Thank you because in Thomas.
Thank you because in Thomas.
You have assured us. To profess our faith.
Unconditionally.
Though not seeing you. But we can say, my Lord and my God. Thank you, Lord, for this profession of faith. That is within us. We hope to glorify you. And journey with you. Forever and ever. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Angel of God. My God and dear, to whom God's love commits me, ever this night be at my side, to guide and guard, rule and guide. Amen. Saint Hannibal,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Send, O Lord.
Holy Apostles of your Church.
Before I give the blessing, we will give Dita 5 minutes to share her story. Dita, are you available?
Yes, you have 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Oh, we have another father.
We welcome Anna Marie.
Wow. Good evening.
Welcome to the family.
Thank you.
Sige, Sal.
Please go ahead, Tita Sal.
I praise and thank God for this day, and it's a blessing for me indeed, because back in April, I was supposed to be inserted with a stent because of my inflamed left kidney, but I requested my urologist and begged off to give me time for at least a month, and luckily he said yes. And when I came back last week, according to him, we no longer have to insert a stent for my left kidney, because from moderately inflamed, it became mildly inflamed. So there's no need for me to be inserted with a stent anymore. All we have to do now is to monitor.
Wow.
Praise God.
Wow.
Wow.
Praise and thank you. That's nice. Work.
Instant healing, instant answer to your prayers.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Actually, when before the scan began, I really prayed to him and I said, Lord, it's all up to you. I give it up to you. Let your will be done. And there it was. Thanks to him, because it was mildly. I know that having a kidney disease will not be, I don't know if it would be healed, but hopefully it will just maintained with, or yung, it will stay as it is, na mildly inflamed lang. And there it is. Thank God for everything.
Wow.
Wow.
Thank you, Lord. Amen. So surgery is not indicated anymore.
Yes.
No more.
No more. Beautiful story. See,
Ate, baka may sharing. Ate, introduce yourself.
Anna Marie.
Hi,
Anna.
I thank you, Dr. Pag. Thank you, Dr. Melinda, for inviting me here sa Koan, sa Zoom-in meeting and sa prayer meeting. Sa ako ang situation is for the Koan, since 2009 na diagnose ko hemolytic anemia, then 2011 na diagnose ko lupus, and then nakaginapon ko ka ng Koan, duha ka Koan surgery. And kapila na ko na, I think four times na ko na admitted due to Kuan sa akong SLE. Ngayon, sa another is ni Kuan, sa akong kanang another admission ako kay tungod sa katong operation ako sa Kuan, sa akong polyp 2018, dinibalik siya Kuan this year lang, January 2024. So I still keep on praying na sana kanang ma ingon sila kay kanang Kuan SLEs kanang for a lifetime na gyud, then but still I'm hoping nga, praying nga, yung di nga ka ng miracle nga, Kuan, ma-kuan sa kuwa din. Karoon is, na ako yung nag-ongoing medication ko para sa kuang Kuan, kay pasin mag, ano siya mo, progress into cancer, and I'm hoping nga, dili lang po doon punta. That's,
we'll pray.
We'll pray for that.
We will pray. Yeah, we will pray.
Pero, pero sa mukha mo, parang wala kang sakit, no? Galing mo naman magdala.
Yeah.
ang galing niyo, ang galing.
Because of God.
Yes. So we bring all those moments and intentions in our prayers, and we ask the Lord really to heal them, to give them the grace, and to bring them to the fullness of their life. It's not an easy one, but with our faith and our common desire and our believing in Jesus, He will give that healing. And then we will pursue our dreams and these global warriors to pray for each other, to pray for those who are sick and for those who are in need of our prayer. So we ask the Lord that grace today, and also asking you the grace for my special intentions. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Wow. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Father.
Thank you so much, Father.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See you.
Bye-bye. See you. Bye-bye, Father. Thank you. Take care, Father.
Take care, Pa.
Thank you.
The three pointers for today's gospel. Number one, in the secular and scientific world, one has to see and verify before one believes. However, faith is a gift from God. We are called to believe in the mysteries of God's revelation, even if we do not see. For example, the real presence of Jesus in the Eucharist. Number two, we also called to believe and in obedience to God's truth in His revealed word and the teachings of the institutional church on dogmas, doctrines, and moral issues. An example, abortions. Number three, do we thank God for the gift of faith? Or are we constantly questioning and being skeptical about what the church teaches as truth? If we are skeptical, we will experience unhappiness with our daily secular living. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Tita Lynn. Please go ahead.
This is from Catholic Mom. We all have times of doubt. We doubt our strength, our abilities, our stamina, our faith. Perhaps we doubt others like our spouses or our children or even our closest friends. And although it may be hard for us to admit, at times we may even doubt God. There are really times in our lives wherein we are challenged by so many hardships, trials in our lives that it really pull us down to the pit of grief, to the pit of hopelessness, that we doubt that God is there. I'm sure each one of us have experienced that at one point in our lives. We may be going through a trial that seems endless, like caring for a colicky newborn, or an aging parent. We may be suffering from a chronic illness or dealing with a headstrong teenager. We may ask God where He is and ask Him why He isn't helping us. We may doubt He is even there at all. It's as if we are abandoned by God. Remember the footprints in the sand, wherein there was just one set of footprints, and the author asked the Lord, where were you at my lowest ebb of my life? Because there was only one set of footprints. And the Lord answered him, because that was when I carried you. So it was the footprints of our Lord, no? Who carried the author. In today's gospel, Thomas proves to us that we can have moments of doubt and still become a saint. Remember that the greatest enemy of our faith is not even doubt, but rather fear. That's the greatest enemy, our fear. He proves to us that although we may stubbornly insist on seeing his movement in our lives for ourselves, he will eventually show up. He proves that reconciliation and renewed faith are more important than my Lord and my God, Thomas cried out. My Lord and my God, we cry out as well. We cry out to him for help, for compassion, for healing, for understanding. We cry out to him in need and in adoration, in our agony and as an act of praise. Dear sisters and brother in Christ, I encourage you to focus today not on Thomas' doubt, but on his proclamation of faith. We profess the same faith and we follow the same Christ, because when Thomas, according to Father Tito, he said that Thomas' questioning really about the resurrection of the risen Lord was not actually out of his doubt, but it was the deepening of his faith. It also deepened our faith, because no matter how often we doubt, we know that his love will always pull us back to where we belong, right by his side. This is so reassuring, right? No?
Yes.
No matter, he will always, where is it? Because no matter how often we doubt, we know that his love will always pull us back to where we belong, right by his side. Meaning, the Lord is always with us. He never abandons us, no matter what. Even if we feel that the heavens are on us because of our problems and our sadness, the Lord is always there. The Lord is always there and ready to answer us if we only call on him. Amen.
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 Beautiful message, Tita Bell, no? From Catholic Mom, no?
The Catholic Mom is really so nice.
Yeah, very practical and applicable ba? Applicable to our modern life, no? Today's message of today's gospel, no? And then itong sinasabi your faith has healed you. Yun, very good message. Because of faith. And then sometimes in our life, no, just like yesterday's gospel, no, sometimes in our life, no, especially during the times of trouble and trials, no, na we found Jesus asleep, he's sleeping.
As if
he is sleeping. No, na Lord, saan ka na? I need you. Tapos here comes Tita Bell saying about this yung poem na Lord, where were you
when the footprints in the sand.
So that those are good reminders, no, that let's just have faith, no, and faith that Jesus will never abandon us. Yeah. We don't focus, just like the Catholic mom said, no, na don't focus on the doubting Thomas. Don't focus on the doubts of Thomas. He's just human. Siguro kung tayo din, no, kung tayo din siguro mag-doubt tayo na sa isang grupo, you are part of the group, but you were not there, no, whatever, wherever you came, no, na I mean wherever you were, no, na somebody very VIP, very important person, no, came and visit, no, and then here you are na sinasabihan ka na, oh, you know what, Jesus was here, and then because of you were not there, so talaga siguro our reaction is, oh, really, let me see his hands, the prints or the wounds on his hand, so that I will believe. So that is doubting Thomas. But according to the message of, it was that Father Tito Bell, na it was the moment of not doubting, but moment of deepening his faith. Yeah, because he was doubting, and then he proclaimed my Lord and my God. Very important anong tawag dyan, ejaculation, no, na my Lord and my God, which we always say that during the Holy Mass, no. My Lord and my God. So life is really well. Just believe. Full 100% trust in on the Lord, and believe, and you know, and for our new members of the family, we are asking for healing. We are always asking for healing, and please remember that all prayers are answered, either instantly, yes, just like Tita Sally, instantly yes. Or maybe wait a minute, or maybe I have something better for you, or, you know, maybe later, or maybe plain and simple, no, because it's not for you. It's not to glorify the Lord. So all prayers are answered. Just believe in time. Don't be like doubting Thomas. Believe. Don't say to see is to believe, just like sa three pointers ni Tita Linda. To see is to believe. No, we have faith. Amen.
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 So
I have also something to say, Tita MJ, if it's okay.
Yeah.
Because I'm actually struck with the way Thomas said, "You are my Lord and my God." So actually, you are my Lord and my God. So we are acknowledging that we really have a Lord and we have a God. Above, although he was that doubtful at first, but then acknowledging him made him put back, no, made him be at the right track. So, and it Jesus also said that happy are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe, in which in one the one reflection it actually refers to us right now that we cannot see Jesus, but actually we can. Jesus is alive, and he is alive, and we can really feel his presence as long as we call on him and we acknowledge his presence in our life. Now, this is not actually, there's a prayer that is always in when I have this, when I'm trying to look for a prayer for the gospel, this prayer has always been open, but so I don't know why. And now we have two new members, so I think it's actually for them, and then although it can also be for us, for all of us. So the prayer actually is the prayer for a purpose. So I'm saying it's for the new members, because your coming here is not how do you call that, when dili siya sulagma. It's not a coincidence.
It's not coincidental.
Yes.
Not serendipitous. Because
you are being called. You are being called by God to be part. And you have a purpose. All of us have a purpose in life. So I really hope that all of us will know the purpose, why we are here in this temporary world. So let me just share this prayer, the prayer for purpose. Father in heaven, you created me for a purpose. Even before I was formed in my mother's womb, you already had a marvelous plan for me and have prepared for me a future full of hope. Align my life with your glorious plan and purpose. Open my mind to know your will. Open my heart to do your will. I surrender my own will and plans to you, that you may completely have your way with me. Amen.
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 Beautiful prayer. Wow. Thank you, Tita Irene.
So nice, Tita.
So, beautiful day that the Lord has made. Special day. Every day is a special day. I think that ends our Zoom prayer meeting today. Tito Manny, do you have a short something? Anything? Tito Manny is our second.
Wala na. Second. Everything has been said. I will just be repeating. Tomorrow, maybe.
Yes, yeah. Okay. Okay, thank you very much for joining. And once again, welcome Tita Sally and Inday Ana Marie.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining. So Miga Bilen for the closing prayer.
Lord, we praise and thank you for this day of prayer and listening to inspiring reflections and good teachings. Please send your Holy Spirit to guide and inspire us. We pray for your guidance and blessings. In Jesus' name, amen.
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 And all together, please, glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
All, thank you very much.
Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you again.
See you tomorrow.
See you again.
Bye-bye. Take care.